let's add the last main instrument and start a symphony of winter energy. This system ensures you both electricity and heat during a blackout with maximum energy efficiency. Finally, it's also good for off-grid living. Hello Energy Champions, and welcome back to our series of Micro Combined Heat and Power, or CHP. I'm Norbert, energy engineer since 33 years. Today in video 83, we are diving into the missing link of this video series and adding a generator to the heat pump of last Sunday. That will complete the technological symphony for an efficient and sustainable home energy solution. Several viewers asked me also to continue with the supercapacitors of the last week, and I am waiting for the new ones to arrive at the end of this month. They have nice big contacts, enough for helping to start the car. In the scheme you see now why I call this system a symphony. Several instruments make a unique combination, and it is amazing what you can accomplish with components that you might have already, and in any case they are common. In particular, I discovered that more households than expected have already a gasoline generator that probably is used on only a few rare occasions. Today's proposal is also for off-grid living. So let's see the scheme and recap the functions and also the advantages. Many of you will see this video without having seen also the previous videos of this same playlist. But also to returning viewers, this combination, this technological combination, is really unique. It has many interrelated issues, and I think a recap is anyway useful. The usual function of a gasoline generator is to make just electricity. This is used in our system
to power the heat pump and other consumers on the house grid.
But a special use of this system is the home battery, allowing two things. Running the generator at nominal power, not at low power, for efficient fuel usage. Storing electricity for many quiet hours without generator, especially when the total power demand is low. The typical air-cooled gasoline generator that many people have discards the heat, diluting this heat into the air as low quality energy. The heat pump's external unit is placed in the same space as a generator, for example your garage. This avoids to put this external part of the heat pump outside in the freezing cold, which seriously decreases the coefficient of efficiency. The heat pump is a champion in converting low-grade diluted heat into useful heat at higher temperature, for example heating your living space. This heat also includes the generator's waste heat at a lower temperature, that of the cylinder and the outer surfaces of this generator, of the engine. And then there's also the high temperature waste heat from the gases here, which you see in this flexible tube, which is kind of nobler because you can do more things with it. For example, domestic hot water or other uses. I just use it for creating low-grade heat in a radiator, also in the garage, but you can install it in another room. Both types of heat, hot gases and engine heat, is energy that you paid for during your visit at the gas station. Now, the nice thing of this product is that the total heat of the generator compensates for the cold air that's produced by the heat pump's external unit. Indeed, you can put the genset in the cold airflow of the heat pump so that it will cool better. In my case, the heat of the generator is about the same when it is going on full power, the same as what this heat pump is taking away. In times when there's no such equilibrium of heat, the garage will simply cool down or heat up slowly as a thermal storage. The heat pump is powered by the generator itself. This and the battery also make the project to a unique combination. However, it is flexible enough to adapt to changes in the way of usage. Let's start now with an important topic, the safety of the generator. When working with gasoline, we are dealing with fire hazard but also toxic gases. These risks might seem alarming, but with proper precautions they are manageable. Think about the cars which we use every day. They are filled with gasoline or diesel and they also produce exhaust gases. For example, if in the winter the car heating system blows a warm air into the car, who says that it isn't mixed with these exhaust gases or vapor of gasoline? No, we feel safe in the car because of the design and the way the ventilation system is made. Also in our system, the generator has its dedicated path for exhaust gas and nothing can escape. So we see here the generator, you see the flexible tube which goes into the radiator. And then from the radiator, the upside, you see this flexible tube, which goes in an aluminium tube upside, and then it goes outside. And with my former system, I saw that the gases, when they leave the radiator, they are really cool, because there's water in the radiator. In the garage is also a CO alarm, with a display that gives the concentration of this dangerous gas in ppm, parts per million. By running the generator at nominal power, we maximize fuel efficiency and prolong also the duration of the generator. This is a true combined heat and power solution, and it is a proven energy saver in the industry. And like in the industry, I give you a solution to the inflexibility of CHP, because it is in some way consuming, making and consuming heat and electricity at the same moment. And you have to deal with that if your demand of electricity and of heat are shifted in time on different moments. Now, with this system, you can bring these benefits which they have already in the industry. If this concept excites you, hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. It's your way to support this content, the domestic energy transition, and stay updated in the last videos in this series. Also, let me know in the comments if you have ever considered that 2/3 of the energy in the fuel is wasted with your generator. This system is also ideal for off-grid living, and here's why. Many off-grid people rely on a generator, on a gasoline generator, and this solution will make it more sustainable and also less noisy. More sustainable because instead of converting 1 liter of gasoline in only 3 kilowatt hours of electrical energy, you also use its 3 kilowatt hours of high temperature energy and 3 kilowatt hour of low temperature heat to warm up your living space and also to use it for special high temperature applications. Maybe something to explore in the next videos. Let me know if you like that. And the usage of this heat will avoid you that you have to look for other solutions to heat your home and spending also the energy for that. It's also less noisy, this solution, because after charging the battery, you can live through the night and through other periods of low consumption, low demand of electricity in complete silence with your battery. If you are one of the people that have a generator but rarely use it, then this is your chance to turn it into a crazy but fascinating project that will also transform how you see energy at your home. Now we come to the concrete part of the video, where I built the new compact generator into the existing system with the heat pump and the home battery. In my case, the high temperature heat is unfortunately used for a less noble application. I dilute it as low temperature heat in the garage with this heavy cast iron radiator. That is something, like I said, that I can find another solution. But I needed also this heat in the garage, because otherwise the heat pump has not enough. And then the garage will go down in temperature over the long run. Oh, that's now in the garage. If I put 6 centimeters, it is not much back pressure. I will put 10 centimeters or a little bit more. Oh yeah, it's 11 centimeters. So that's 5 centimeters of back pressure. With this meter, you see also the PPM reading. Ten. Twenty. 30. 100. A quarter turn. And next time I want it to fit. And 10. So it's 58 ppm, so I have to improve something here. I think it's really the outlet of the generator. I will put some paste of it in it. Anyway, with 62, the alarm is not yet going. at the other side of their garage. Well, that's very silent. My voice arrives at 54. And I can smell. I don't hear any motor noise. I don't know how why their focus is not working, but the heat pump is working very well. I really feel it. So now I want to start with the battery. I want to switch this and set it on. I hope you liked this video. This micro CHP system is really a game changer for anyone looking to save energy, become independent and explore innovative do-it-yourself solutions at your home. It's not just about technology, it's really about empowering yourself to take control over your energy future. If you're ready to take on this project, then check the articles that you can buy at Amazon. It will support me with a small commission that you don't have to pay. Amazon will pay it. Write your comments under the video. I just started to use this system in all its complexity and I am sure that the system can be improved. Thank you for watching and interacting with me. Look also to the other videos in this playlist. I wish you good energy.